Good evening and welcome to the Quarry Valley Unified Union School District meeting. Today is January 2nd, 2024. If you'd all please join me for the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Peg TV's gonna have to edit.
Yeah. All right, approval of the agenda. I need to add under personnel, contract recommendations and resignations.
I'll make the motion.
Motion by Mike. Any further discussion? Hearing none. All those in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion passes unanimously. General public comment. Is there anyone from the public that would like to speak to an issue? Seeing none. Moving on. Lewis has informed me that we have some budget issues we need to discuss. So we are going to go back to new business after we discuss the budget updates. All right? So approval of minutes.
Oh, and the old business community engagement, we're going to put that on hold too, right?
Yeah, well, I think that's the same as your budget talking points, isn't it?
Yeah.
She just put it on for two things.
Yeah.
I'll make the motion.
A motion would be in order to approve the minutes of December 14th. Motion by Mike. Any discussion? Hearing none. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion passes unanimously. Approval of warrants. You receive your warrants via your GRC issue email. All questions and comments should be directed to Lewis. A motion would be in order for approval of the warrants.
So moved.
Motion by Kristen. Any discussion? Hearing none. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion passes unanimously. Finance.
So unfortunately, I have a trifecta of bad news tonight when it comes to budgets. So the first piece regarding the expense side, in our last budget discussions, looking at second draft of the budget for the vocational tuition, we were using the numbers that we were given by Stafford to determine what our vocational tuition would be. Last week, the state sent out their numbers, and they were quite a bit different than what Stafford had provided us. So looking back at Stafford's information, there was an error in their calculation, and that is resulting in $124,000 in additional expense by using the state numbers. So that's the first one. The second one is we received a revised pupil count from the state, and our pupils have dropped by approximately 20 students. 20 students has approximately a 2 cent impact on our tax rate. And the last piece is, earlier tonight I reported that we were still waiting on CLAs, but actually in the middle of the GRCSU board meeting, I did receive an email from the state that the CLA data was posted online this evening. And we have drops in CLA ranging from 10 to 11% for each of our districts, which is having a very significant impact on tax rates. So right now, Pulteney's CLA is at 80.73, Proctor is at 79.61, and West Rutland is at 78.69. So based on the budget that was approved, plus the vocational tuition amount, the new pupil count, and the CLAs, we're looking at a unified tax rate that is up approximately 5 cents, which is 4.1% increase. But after the CLA adjustment, we are looking at a tax rates that are up by approximately 21 cents for Pulteney and Proctor and 20 cents for West Rutland.
So, since we approved, how do we procedurally do that as a board?
We could open back up the budget.
So we do the whole process again, essentially. Okay. Okay.
Questions?
So if we accept it as it is, what does that show for, what would be sending to the taxpayer? What were we spending and what would we be sending? Just roughly.
So right now, we would be sending a budget to the taxpayers based on, I mean, the piece that's still unknown is the yield.
No, just.
And so right now, we would be sending a tax rate that is approximately 21 cents higher, which is ranging anywhere between 15.4 to 16.9%.
This is why they should give us the CLA before December 15th, which is what they're supposed to do.
Yep.
Can't do that.
So in terms of the warning, that's Article 7, what is that number? Instead of the 21,035,093.55.
21,159,175.55.
Say it again.
21,159,179.55.
Plus $130,000 difference.
So last month when we were looking at a tax rate that was up approximately 4.5 cents.
Mm-hmm. We split it in the middle. And now what are we up again, Lewis? I'm sorry.
We are up approximately 21 cents.
So 15%, 16.7?
It's 16.9 for Pulteney, 16.2 for Proctor, and 15.4 for West Rutland.
Nobody wants to put that on a trifold.
Nope.
Not gonna work.
Unfortunately, the CLA is hard to overcome. So you would have to make really significant cuts to overcome the CLA.
What are you talking about as a number? Just for example. So.
Well, if you wanted to get it back to the 4.5%.
I mean, $100,000 doesn't even move it a penny. Right. I mean, right. So $160,000 for a penny. Right. So, I mean, if you wanted to drop it down 10 cents, you're talking $1.6 million.
It's not going to pass.
No.
While we ponder those numbers, can we get the other work? If we get everything else done, then we can come back to this. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
To kind of clear our plates. For contract information, extracurricular, we have Jake Eaton, varsity boys basketball coach, $2,625, which is a stipend that's prorated. And Matt Parker, varsity boys basketball coach, $875, a revised stipend. A motion would be in order to approve the contract recommendation as presented.
I'll make that motion.
Motion by Kristen. Discussion. Yes.
Two varsity coaches?
No.
It says two varsity coaches?
No. It says one is, it does, but if you look at your next page.
It's going to, yeah.
Yeah. Okay. A motion will be in order to, any discussion? Hearing none. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion passes unanimously. Retirement resignations. For retirement, we have Mr. Mott from Proctor High School retiring the end of FY24. For resignation, you have Matt Parker, Proctor High School boys varsity coach, effective 1/1/2024, and Rebecca Hamilton, Proctor Elementary Pre-K Para, effective upon receipt of AOE approval for licensure in order to move to a GRCSU special ed teacher position. A motion would be in order.
I'll make the motion.
It should be noted that Mr. Mott is seeking buyout compensation for teachers who have served more than 20 years and payment for unused sick time, which he is eligible for. Any discussion? I will say that there were tears in my house when it was mentioned that Mr. Mott is retiring. He has been at Proctor High School, or he has been teaching for 30 years, and it is going to be a sad day when he is no longer there. And I accept this retirement very regrettably. It's going to be a significant hole within the Quarry Valley teachers. So he is an incredible instructor.
What did he teach? I'm sorry.
History.
Oh, yeah.
Model UN, AP history. Spectacular. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion passes unanimously. Policies. We have pre-K kindergarten, FA pre-K kindergarten admission as a second read. A motion would be in order to approve the second read.
So moved.
Motion by Linda. Discussion? Hearing none. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Motion passes unanimously. E9 animals on school grounds. We just sent that back at the prior meeting, back to policy. So for first reads, we have F2, search and seizure of students and property by school personnel. A motion would be in order to move on as a second read.
Motion
by Mike. Discussion? Hearing none. All those in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion passes unanimously. All right. Back to the Trail of Tears. What is the pleasure of the board with the new information on the budget?
So what would be the percentage we would be asking the people if we
16.9 in Fulton, 16.2 in Proctor, 15.4 in West Rockland. Anyone feel comfortable with those numbers?
No.
Lisa?
Yeah.
Can I make a suggestion to the board? And I know I'm not trying to add more meetings to my or any of our schedules, but I learned of this afternoon as well, and I think that Bill and Evans are probably here about this the first time, and I think with that, I don't think it's really fair for the board or for us to try to make a decision tonight. With all this, I think we have to go back. I think the admin group has to do some strategizing. Similar to what we did prior to the break, where we came back with some proposals, I think it would be prudent for us to come back, you know, as an admin group, look at what numbers may look like, and then the week of maybe the 16th of January, we'll come back, discuss this, and then look to make a motion there. But I think there's just a lot for the admin, I think the board to continue take in tonight. It's just a lot, and I don't think it's necessarily fair for anyone to make a decision tonight. I think there's a lot of work that we need on our end to try to get that number down.
Yep, that sounds good. I think there should be some kind of general discussion, though. Well, so we're not sending you back just blind. I mean, if the board is knowing what these numbers are, knowing what Lewis said, if you're knocking 10 cents off what you're looking at, what number the board, or what two or three numbers the board is going to be happy with you looking at to try to make some impactful changes around. So knowing what the numbers are, knowing we were at 4.5%, and that was a pretty good fight for us to get to that. And at these numbers over here, what is a number or two numbers you want to send to Chris and building admins to have them reassess the budget and come back? I mean, if they came back at 8%.
No, 10%.
We can't, I mean, how can you run a school without teachers and without, you know, I don't see how we could lower it to 8%. Maybe 10, I don't know.
Is there any way we can combine? I know we have extra, like we have the wellness center, for example. Is there a way that we have, do we have any room in any of our schools down the road where we could host something like that inside of our schools, school buildings?
There's yeah, no but that's room. Not, in, that's an SU that, issue. That's not SU. Impact. Okay. That's not going to
so
impact.
So that's not going to help us at
that's
all.
That's not going to impact us here. So
okay, so
that's based on SU, that's based on who we're sending. So there's not numbers there that are going to, unless we're going to garner rent or something from the SU. And at this point, we barely have room in our buildings to do what we're doing. So, I mean, but the goal here currently is we need to come just to what that number is that you can walk in your community and discuss and sell to send it, give to Chris to meet with his building admin for them to reassess the budget and for them to come back and say.
I do know that the selectmen that I've spoken with in Pulteney are saying that it's becoming ridiculous that, you know, we're in the 73, 77 cents per dollar spent on taxes going towards the schools. That's what I was told. I haven't seen any documentation stating that, supporting that, but that's what I was told. So I know that if we come back at 16.9%, that's not going to fly.
Yeah.
And even if we double it, that's 9%. Right.
Right.
So
well, I thought we
9%
did
6% would be double.
Percent.
The number on the warning would have been 4.5 that we came to.
Oh, I thought.
Right?
Didn't we agree on 6?
No. We were up 6%. Education
we
spending
up 6%.
Was up 6%.
So if we doubled it, it'd be 12.
Mm-hmm. Which is even worse.
Which is worse.
Yeah. Right.
Well,
that's what I'm saying.
You're not talking apples and apples. Yeah. Like, you're talking education spending versus
right,
tax rate.
I mean, I don't.
And there's
I wasn't
a lot of
trying
factors.
To pick on the wellness
okay.
center.
Right.
Yeah.
But I'm just saying, do you have any ideas on the top of your head of things that you can cut?
Well, that's why if we give them that's why we need to give them the number for them all to set and figure out.
Okay.
So if we were at 6% and now it's more than doubled, would we be happy saying to them, come back at 7.8% or 8%? Or and what would those cuts look like?
The tricky part is I don't want to see cuts that are going to hurt the children or hurt,
right, but
hurt any of the
teachers. Until
we
give them a number and they sit down, we aren't going to know what those cuts are. So we need to tell them. They're going to come back and tell us what.
Of course, we don't want to hurt the we don't want to hurt the kids.
Right.
But we also have to keep in mind the taxpayers
right.
are always footing the bill.
Yeah.
And they don't want to hurt the kids either, but there's only so much burden they
it's,
can carry.
It's a tricky balancing act we're going to have to play here.
Yeah. So if we say 8%, Chris is going to sit down with them, and then they're going to come back and say, this is what 8% looks like. This is what we're going to take away.
How about 8 and 10%?
Well, you're still not talking the same type of numbers here.
I know.
Education spending right now is up 6.76%. What's within our control hasn't grown that much. It's what's outside our control. So we were last meeting we were at 6%. It was like 6.08 or 6.07 something. So rounds up 6.08. Right now we're at 6.76. That's where our control ends. It's the tax rate that's up the 16.9, 15.4%. And that's because there's factors outside our control, like the yield and the CLA, that happen after that calculation.
So how do we address it?
What are within those calculations? I don't understand those calculations, so you have to educate me.
After
outside of our control.
After we have after we determine what our education spending is going to be, which is we take our total expense minus any local revenues to get our education spending. The first piece of the calculation is to take your education spending divided by the number of pupils. So last month we talked about Act 127 and how that pupil count changed. That number is frozen. I mean, there's no changing that. That was based on the change in the law, which didn't have a huge impact on Corey Valley. the next point in the calculation is dividing that by the yield. The yield is set by the legislators. Right now we're using the recommendation from the tax commissioner from December 1st. Right, we're using a yield of 9,452. We have no control over that number. The legislators will decide what that number is. We won't know what that number will be until after budgets already go to the voters. Right now, we just have a recommendation from the tax commission to use for the purposes of our budget.
It's like we're going to have to take the $1 million out and use it to, you know.
And then the last piece that's having the biggest impact is the common level of appraisal. So we take our total tax or unified tax rate divided by the common level of appraisal to get what our adjusted tax rate would be. So if you're at a dollar and you had it, right now we're at $1.19, you take divide that by 80%, which is the CLA for most of our towns, you know, you're looking at tax rates of $1.48, $1.50. So those three pieces we have no control over. Those are all state level calculations and decisions. So if we were to take $1,020,000 out, it would get us to an average increase of 10% over our three towns. That's in tax rate. That same $1 million, if we take out that same $1 million, it brings our education spending to an increase of only 1.1%.
Now, what does that do to us next year? Is that like a
sword over our head
penalty kind, you know what I mean? Like if you buy, you know.
No, I mean, because we're not using one-time revenue. We'd actually be cutting expenses. But I mean, $1 million is hard to find. I mean, that's a lot of staff members. I mean, we're not cutting staples and notebooks and paper with $1 million.
So it's 1% is 1 point. 160,000 is 1 point. Is that what you're saying?
160,000 is 1 penny.
Oh, 1 penny.
So 8% and 10% to send to Chris and have him come back in a special meeting with recommendations from building admin. Are those numbers that if he came back with, people could support 8 or 10%?
I won't be here the 16th. Just saying.
That'll reflect in the real.
No, we'll find a date
okay,
when people
good.
Are going to be here. We're not going to. Yes, Linda. What date are you not going to be here? Because we're going to approve.
See, this Sign is why we get up. Along.
Circle that date.
Make sure when you're not going to be here, you're going to call the meeting, 100%.
Thank you. You are so good to me.
Are 8 and 10%, if those are the numbers they came back with, are those I mean, are those numbers that, or different numbers? 7 and 11, 9 and 12.
1 and 2.
1 and 2, yeah. I don't think we'll have to have many more meetings if it's 1 and 2.
I think maybe, like Chris was saying, they need time to kind of take a look at it and then present something to it.
Yeah.
Right, but we need to give them that number. We need to give them the...
Shoot for.
Yeah. 7 and 10.
What's that?
7 and 10?
Yeah, I'd go 7 and 10.
Yeah, I could do that.
And can you make a...
In tax rate? Yeah.
Yes, in the tax rate. Yes.
Not that that's going to be easy.
Well, we know the bottom end is 7, and the top end is 10. We've got room in between if we have to, but at least we know we can make it at 7, right?
You can sell that to people? That's what I'm saying. I don't think
so. That's between $1 and $1.5 million.
If we come in with two numbers, then we have to come back and adjust.
$1 and $1.5 million.
Yes.
10% is roughly $1 million, and 7% will be $1.5 million.
Okay. Okay, Chris. Where are the balloons now, Chris?
I don't know how you did that.
It's a gut punch.
Yeah, I mean, and all it is coming back. That doesn't mean anything. I mean, that's just coming back. Yeah. That's still a...
We might do something else.
We don't know what other district... I mean, not that we should base what we do on other districts, but we don't know the impact. It's going to have an impact across the whole state.
Yeah, Castleton was already...
CLAs are down an average of 7%.
And CLAs are going to change everything also in municipalities that have approved budgets.
I don't think municipalities base their taxes on CLAs.
No. Oh, really?
Yeah.
No.
So municipalities, it's dollar for dollar.
Okay.
It's only school taxes that are equalized across the state.
Okay.
That's why it's cheaper. It's cheaper.
I think they use it in the appraisal, right? But not in the...
Oh, because they were waiting. Said they were waiting for it. Okay.
Yeah.
Will you finish that sentence you just started?
It's cheaper to raise a town dollar than it is a school dollar because town dollars are dollar for dollar. School dollars are equalized. So if you're... and it depends on whether you're in a goal town or not, but...
The downside is the town has responsibility for the CLAs.
In a sense, they do. Exactly, they do. Because
they're in charge of reappraisals.
Right.
So next year we are going to be in the same place because no one's getting reappraised for at least another year. At least till 2026.
And this is outside of all the Act 127 stuff that you were talking about that could come in the future.
Correct. Yeah.
Act 127 ends at the district level. CLA affects the town level.
Yeah.
And reappraisals, in theory, across the town don't have any impact on your taxes because what it's doing is it's bringing your CLA back up to 100, but it's raising everybody's assessed value. So if you're assessed at 75% and your value of your home was at 100,000, now your home value is going to go to 100, let's say 150, and you're going to be at 100%. So you're being assessed based on a higher value at a lower percentage.
But the reality is most people don't pay full taxes without getting some kind of...
Correct. I mean, this doesn't take into account any income sensitivity.
Right. And so that's the other piece that... It's difficult to discuss, but is a reality for a majority of our towns and community members. So when people are talking about this number, the number of people in our communities that receive those rebates or whatever they're called, we did that a number of years ago, and the number is pretty substantial. So that's the other thing that taxpayers have to remember. Because you're not paying based on income, you're paying based, so. Anyway, all right, so that's the number, 7 and 10, and then we'll hold a special meeting and go from there.
And Lewis, you can present that information kind of like you did.
No, we don't have a date. We don't have a date.
You can present that information in sort of the same kind of draft. Like, so what 7 or 10 would look like?
I'll present a tax rate.
Yeah, like the whole stuff that you.
The budget proposals.
Yeah.
Just because you go to.
Then I can retain more when it's all in front.
I don't think so.
All right, anything else to come before the board?
Have a good time.
So the talking points will be crucial.
So the talking points are going to be after we figure out what this is.
But also crucial to.
We will let you know, let's say by the beginning of next week, when we'll meet, because we're going to have to let them all get together and talk, meet with Lewis.
We have a rough idea? I just need more than a day's notice, that's all.
Yeah, I can't, there's a couple days I can't do.
I can do the 23rd.
We can't be, what's the latest we can be?
Do you have the publication deadlines and things we need to have?
The 20th is the first day we can issue a warning. I don't know if the 30th day is, I don't have it up right in front of me.
Okay, hold on.
30 days from the 20th?
Second, so.
No, it's the first day.
Yeah, right.
Yeah.
So we don't need to be worried about that. We need to be worried about what's the latest we could submit it. That's what we need to be, because we need to know what the back end is, the worst possible.
29th is our deadline.
So ideally, I think we should meet the week of this, the 15th through the 19th, because if we do need another meeting, we have a little bit of buffer.
Another week, yeah.
Okay.
Because if we would have to schedule a second meeting, we could do that, but if we meet the 23rd, then we're really up against the wall.
What about, okay, what about the 15th? Does that work
that's
for
Martin
people?
Luther, but that's, huh? That's Martin Luther.
I would suggest middle.
What about the 17th?
At least the middle of the week.
I can't either. I'm gone until the night, till the 20th.
We got to have it before that.
I'm gone the 16th through the 20th.
17th or 18th. Absolutely not the 17th. 18th is probably not going to happen either.
Can we do the 15th? So 17, 18, and 19 is already out for three people.
How about the 15th?
That's what I'm saying.
Federal holiday.
That's MLK.
Not a problem for me, any.
I don't, you know.
This is publication.
Yay, Martin Luther, but no.
I don't know.
It's the warning deadline.
Building's closed.
So.
This building, here.
Yeah, it's all closed on MLK. There's no.
That's what I'm saying.
Principals are all.
What about the 12th, which is a Friday?
I'm out of country.
Oh.
Out of country? Out of boy.
Montreal.
Is it policy meeting that night?
I can't do the.
I can reschedule the policy.
Yeah, I can't be here on the 22nd.
Well, I don't schedule those. Those are, those go with Chris's schedule, so.
We're down to the 23rd.
I can do the 15th. I can do the.
I can do the 16th.
What day are you leaving?
The 16th.
Could we jam one in like 10th or 11th or 12th? Or no, that's too early.
Lewis is away.
Oh.
Federal day.
Do it without me.
I don't have time for that.
He could just zoom in from the Dominican Republic.
Go over well.
They need to have time to go over it. So that's all next week. They need that time. So shouldn't be before the 15th.
Can we do the 15th? Or because it's MLK, it's going to be too problematic for everybody. Everybody's away.
15th.
Yeah, I don't think it's
right.
The admins, that's a day off for the admins.
Okay. Well, I don't know when
I mean, I'm fine if I can meet, but I would ask that the admins not be at the present meeting or required to be at that meeting.
No. Mm-hmm. I mean, I would say they've already done the work with you, so you're bringing it forward.
Yeah, it's a matter of.
We'll give up time, but I think we have to be respectful of everyone's time, too.
100%, but we need to have a quorum here, and we need to have, so.
I understand.
And that week of the 22nd is too late, is that?
Yeah, because it doesn't give us a chance to, if we need to.
Yeah, no, go back and forth, I mean, yeah.
Right. 16th,
Linda?
Hmm?
You're not here on the 16th?
I'm not here through the week. I leave on the 16th, and I don't come back till the, I'm here the 15th. Yeah.
I can do
okay. I mean,
15.
Looked like the day. No?
Can you do 15?
I can do 15.
It's hard for Chris, but.
I can do the weekend, but
Weekends are better for me.
Same time, 7 p.m. or earlier, or is it going to be a long meeting, maybe? So maybe we should start earlier if we can.
If you go much before 6 and you're in the people's dinner hours.
Right.
Six, unless you're going to feed them.
Right. Right.
We clearly
budget cut right there.
When are you leaving?
I leave.
Move it from 5 to 6,
Friday.
Budget cut.
Fly out Saturday. Right.
No, no
on
mail.
The 6th?
And there it is. Next Saturday, yeah, the 13th.
Oh, you like it? You thought this was going to be fun.
I thought we were like, good, I can sign the warning while I'm here.
I don't know. So what's the pleasure? I mean, the 15th seems to be the time when we're going to have a quorum of people. So I don't, I mean, either that or we do it the week prior and we don't have Lewis. And I don't know what you're feeling on that.
I think
Chris.
We need.
I think we can.
I know, but I'm asking the superintendent.
I think we need Lewis at this meeting.
Okay.
Yeah.
I understand. It is just a little disappointing that, you know, and I'll just say this, but, you know, that we're looking at the 15th, which is a day off for our staff, you know, to get a quorum, but we're working around other people's schedules, but we don't work around admin schedules. So it is a little frustrating.
I don't think we should.
And I have to speak on behalf of the admin team. So
was there another day that week when we have a quorum, understanding that that might not mean everybody, which I know is also not ideal, but.
Well, we have three members out for 17, 18, 19.
We'll do it the 16th.
And what did we have on the 16th?
Can you join? Can you join virtually?
I'm on a plane.
Oh.
I'm sorry.
Change the time. Leave it alone. You're only going to Florida. You should be there.
If I had known this, I would not have booked it.
Could we? What time are you leaving?
Could we do an early morning meeting?
Well, some people
have
to work.
I'm just trying to think out the box here.
We'll have to work.
On the 16th, could we have an 8 a.m. meeting? Or, I don't know.
I don't know.
Okay, if we did, what's the problem with the 23rd is just too late,
right.
Chris?
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Well, we're getting to a point where we're getting close to that 30-day window. It's not necessarily too late. It's just we have to have a decision made at that meeting and then have the get the warning approved and then signed. So it's a very quick turnaround. So it can be done, but it just we have to make sure that there's no we're going to have another meeting after that. We have to make a decision that night.
Well, the warning is essentially everything but the number. I mean, the warning is already set up, right, and good to go. I mean, the warning we had tonight is fine with the exception of the number being incorrect.
How many days, Chris, how many days do you think your admin needs to put numbers together to work out some sort of solution?
Well, I mean, I think
we'll
look at Lewis and we'll take a look at the numbers and, you know, we can...
But Lewis is
gone. Right.
Well, sorry. We have to meet this week. You know, Lewis hired we'll probably have to meet on Friday and just start hacking away at it. And I shouldn't say hacking away, that's so terrible. But looking at this.
Could we meet?
We need additional time.
What's
we can
the
meet
early
after the parade.
The 23rd?
There's just a lot.
On the 23rd?
Yeah.
Yeah. Just trying to see if we could do something before the
4 o'clock.
Anytime.
Could people meet? What if can people meet at 4 o'clock on the 23rd?
Yes.
Well, 4:30.
What is the advantage of meeting early? Is it you think you're gonna have a 6-hour meeting? Is that why or?
I think it's easier the later the hour goes, the harder it becomes, and this is what happens, that when people meet.
You guys have been here for a while. I'm fresh and ready to go, but right. I wasn't here in the last
okay.
meeting. You guys have been here.
I mean, 6 o'clock?
Early task would be just that.
Yeah, yes. That would be the only task, right. Just that.
So I don't think we should try to go too much earlier.
Then how about 6 o'clock on the 23rd, knowing that there has to be an answer. There's no wiggle room. And that way, if people are here, then we can print off the warning and everybody can sign it when they're here then too. So, two birds, one stone.
Could we maybe have, since we got to come up with a decision that day, could we have some kind of documents to help make our decision and discuss it online? Whether it's a chain email or something.
Oh, no, we cannot do that. No. That's a violation of open meeting. But some of this stuff is going to probably fall into personnel and executive session, so it's going to get
warned properly.
Okay.
No, it's just going to be, I think it could be questionable sharing out everything in the.
Yeah, in the, right.
Yeah, in the drive. Because if you're talking about personnel, you don't want to be doing that.
Okay, that was just a question.
So how about the 23rd, 6:00?
Okay.
And then we'll sign the warning that night. Whatever we're doing, we're doing.
I'm stuck with it.
That's it. There's no getting out of it.
Can you repeat that one more time? 23rd.
Huh?
Can you repeat that one more time?
January 23rd, which I believe is a Tuesday.
It is.
The last day we can.
At 6:00.
Yeah, I think Chris said we've got 30 days from that day, right?
The 20th is the 40th day, so the clock starts. We have
the 40th
is the earliest we can warn, the 30th, or the 30 days is the last day to warn. So I do believe it. Probably the 30th, which is after. I'll double check that.
Yeah.
We could
have
another.
I
don't.
We could have a Thursday meeting if we needed to.
If we need to, yeah.
On
just
the 25th.
This is the day, and that's it. It's not.
Yeah. I mean, the last to warn it, you mean to put it in the book? Is that what you mean?
To warn it, like, at the post office and the town office and stuff like that.
Okay.
It has to be posted.
Yeah. Okay.
You have to print it.
Our deadline for that is the 29th. But.
Okay.
23rd, if it gets screwed up, we can still
do it 25th or something.
Okay.
Yeah, but I mean, coming with the idea that the 23rd is what we're going to do. Yeah,
but
come with your decision making hat on.
Have a plan, too.
Right.
Okay. Everybody's good with that? 23rd. Building admin, good? 23rd? I do think even if building admin join us virtually, it is important that they are participating. I think it's better that if you can be in person, it's a lot easier to have conversations around these things. And knowing that
6:00.
If we're looking at 7% and 10%, those are pretty big hits. We want to hear that. So I would appreciate if possible if you could be here. I'll even bring chocolate for Jim.
Thank you to the board for considering the admin's time. I appreciate that.
All right. So we will see you on the 23rd at 6:00 here, and with the only is the budget and the warning. All right. If there is nothing else to come before the board,
motion to adjourn.
All right. Adjourn at 8:10. All those in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion passes unanimously. Thank you. Thank you, Chris. Feel better.